Tuned for the next episode where me and my dad actually went go-kart racing. I want you guys to comment below since it's super hot outside. What's your favorite ice cream? I know that's random, but like, what's your favorite ice cream? Today, we're gonna be going over my boat for 2018, the old Ranger, guys. I've had this thing for a while. You guys have been asking for a updated boat tour for such a long time now, so now we're actually getting to it. As I stated in the last video where I completely took everything out of the boat, all the tackle, everything. If you guys want to go check that one out, I'll link it below. If you guys haven't seen my dad's reaction, I'll link that below as well. It's freaking hilarious. You guys need to go watch that one. And yeah, so let's go ahead and get this boat tour started. Just yet. We're gonna start off with everything on the outside. So coming over to the back. On the back, we got a Yamaha 250 show four string. This thing's awesome, guys. I absolutely love it. I would never switch to another mode. I mean, the Yamaha show, the show is just outstanding. I absolutely love it. You know, we had a two stroke before, just guzzling on the oil. I mean, it's so much better. If you can afford this, if you can get this, I would highly recommend getting the Yamaha show. And then we got power poles on the back. As you can tell, we actually got those wrapped. And I would show you my prop, but I don't have my new one on yet, so I'm not even gonna show you that yet. Moving over to the grass, I actually have two nines right here, Lowrance, and I got an HDS 12 right there in the front. I actually really like this combo. It's perfect because when I'm, you know, when I'm riding, even when I'm scanning, you know, I can have my map on one, I can have my sonar, my down scanner, my side scan on the other. It's just like a perfect combo. Moving over here to the front, like I said, I got an HDS 12 by Lowrance, and then I got the old Ultrex, which I absolutely just about destroyed at the Red River. I put some damage on it, but this is by far a game changer. Like, I'm not even affiliated with Minn Kota, guys, but if you are going to buy a trolling motor, it is worth the extra money. Just listen to me. It is worth the extra money to get this thing. It is absolutely outstanding. I never really realized how much of a difference it can make, because if you're out there fishing ledges, you know, you can lock yourself into place, or if you're fishing brush piles, you can press a button, literally lock yourself in a place, and you don't have to move around and worry about, you know, all the waves coming by. It's just gonna stay there. And so, say you hooked a fish, lock yourself in place, you're not gonna be moving around. Also, I have a hydro wave up in the front as well. Let's hop into the inside. We're gonna start in the front of the boat, guys, with these compartments. We got two right here, one in the middle. Of course, we got the cooler, and then we got the rod compartment right here. I'm gonna start off with the rod compartment. So, as you guys know, in the last episode, I talked about everything, cleaned everything out, that whole deal. I actually stuffed some of my rods in here right now, and if you look very closely, you can see there's a good bit of line in the bottom. Me and my dad actually went out on the lake today, and it's gonna be pretty funny. He messed up pretty hard, so you guys need to stay tuned for that video. I don't know what I'm gonna call it yet, but he was going crazy. He was raging a lot, so stay tuned for that video. So guys, I know I've said in my other videos, you know, most of the time I usually don't like, you know, the rod compartments. You know, it's really hard because everything gets all tangled up. It's just a big mess, and I really don't like using them. You know, if I'm traveling, I'm usually putting the rods in my truck, or my rod tubes are in the back of my truck, trying to really stay away from the rod compartment in general. But one thing that I do is I actually have rod gloves. If you guys don't know what rod gloves are, they actually go over the end, so it's covering your line. So when you put them in here, it's not gonna sit there and tangle up. So this is actually gonna help a lot. And I'm not just saying that, I mean, it really does, because I will rarely put my rods in there unless I have rod gloves on. I have a few rods already in there, but they actually don't have a reel on them, so I'm not really having to worry about that. But if you guys wanna check out the rod gloves, I actually sell some on my website, Kickin' Their Bass TV brand. I actually have the logo here on the side. Blue ones and the green ones, you can check them out on my website. Alrighty, guys, moving on to the middle compartment. As you guys can tell, it is a lot better than it was a few weeks ago. It was absolutely just destroyed. So, and I'm not just talking about my dad's baits, it was pretty messy in general. I haven't got to actually deep clean this. I know if you guys watched the last video, I said I was gonna deep clean, you know, the whole insides and that whole deal. I haven't had a chance to, but I did stuff my tackle that I usually keep in here. And so let me kind of show you what I got in here. So first box right here, I know you guys can't see it. I have all my boxes labeled, as you can tell.
pretty much all organized by their names. So this one, we have all jerk baits. We got walking topwater baits in this one. Fish head spins in this one. Drop shot worms, flukes and paddle tails. We got hooks. We have actually my new Senko in a river box in there. That's actually my buddy's box they left in my boat. Spy baits, finesse worms, hard body swim baits, crawl trailers, drop shot box, and then a terminal tackle box, which is pretty much my weights, bobber stops, swivels, that whole deal. Pretty much, I really like to keep it organized by this. And when I go back to Savannah, and when I'm gonna be fishing the river a lot, you're gonna see that the baits in my boat are gonna vary. You know, they're gonna change. They're not gonna be, you know, like spy baits, hard body swim baits, fish heads. They're gonna change to, you know, square bill crankbaits and chatter baits, spinner baits. You know, I'm gonna have a different variety just because out here on Lake Lanier, it's a whole different fishery than the river. So I'm gonna be changing stuff out. But that's what I got in there. Then on the sides, I actually have this box, which I actually have some tools in, screwdrivers, some pliers, and some other tools in there. And I have a med kit right here. I also have another one of those I'll show you guys. I got a box with sunscreen in there. Very important, something I never do, as you guys can tell. And then on the side, I just have a big old MagDraft swim bait. But that's about it in that box right there. I have more tackle in the back, which I'll show you guys here in a moment. The two compartments right here are actually gonna be very simple. They're not as interesting as these two right here, obviously, because I have the rods and a majority of the baits in this one. But let's start off with this 13 fishing box right here, and I'll show you guys what I have in it. So I like to keep it pretty packed with life jackets. I got some of my safety equipment in here, as you guys can tell. I got an air horn, got a flag, orange flag. I got some forks, spoons, just some stuff that, you know, you never know what I'm gonna need. I got some waterproof shoes in there. I got my rain suit, which is actually freaking awesome. I'm gonna show you guys this because a lot of you guys ask about it. This is actually by Under Armour. As you can tell, it's got a sick finish on it. It is awesome, guys. A lot of you guys have been asking about this thing, and you guys want to know my opinion on it, so I might as well add it in. You know, a lot of people are running the 100 mile per hour suits. They're not a bad suit. It's pretty good. It's really great for the money. This is going to be a little bit more of an investment, but I can tell you one thing: it's not as big, it's not as bulky, and it's still going to keep you warm. It's going to keep the water off you, and it's going to be easier to get around in. Because that's my biggest problem with the 100 mile per hour suits. I've owned, you know, a ton of different brands, including the 100 mile per hour suit. And it's just so big and bulky, and I can't stand that when I'm fishing, especially when it's cold outside. You're gonna have to bundle up. So when you're trying to throw and cast, that one just seems to be too bulky for me. But this Under Armour one fits me fairly well. This last little compartment right here, guys, very simple. I got some ropes, got some hats, got some hoo rags for my neck. If you guys want to check them out, links below. I actually protect your neck, which is very important, which I should probably do because I never put sunscreen on. But I got some floats in there, some spare life jackets, some gloves, hats, pretty much everything that, you know, I'm gonna need. Say I was driving down the lake, my hat flew out, I always have spares in there. It actually happened to me at the national championship. You know, things happen, so always come prepared. Moving down into the middle of the boat, there's really not much going on. As you guys can tell, I got the two main seats. I do not have a dual console, one right here. I like it without one here just because there's a lot more room. I have a lot of my buddies that have the double consoles like that. I just prefer just one, personally. I know it's kind of the co-angler's decision in a way, but I just really think it looks a lot cleaner with just one. And most of the time, like if I'm out there, I'm by myself or, you know, obviously fishing those college events. But right here is actually where I keep my net, right there. And there is my cooler. And also right here, I actually have, you know, all my pliers. Golly, burn my butt. Guys, it is hot. It is hot out here. It's like literally 100 degrees out here making this video. We're dripping sweat. It is bad. Got other pliers right here, some snippers, some cutters. These are absolutely amazing. If you guys need to buy a pair of cutters, I need to go buy a new pair because mine are getting kind of dull. It's called the boomerang tool. This thing is sick. Like, I just stick it in there, and I've been using this thing for years. I really need to buy a new one. It's not getting as sharp. Got some scissors. Right here, I actually got speakers in the boat that connect to my
Lowrance Graphs is a rock for phosgates. They actually bump pretty hard, guys. The only thing that I just dislike about them is I don't get to use them all the time. But it's kind of like a me thing. Like, it's my problem, because when I'm recording, if it picks up all that audio, it's going to actually throw strikes towards my channel and everything. So I can't really listen to music much unless I'm not filming. And I'm going to be honest with you, I'm pretty much filming 24/7. So I rarely get to use them. But when I do, they bump. Right here, got the little, I guess you could say, glove box. That's where I keep, you know, some butt ribbon to wipe my butt just in case I have to run in the woods. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. Insurance, fishing license, that whole deal, everything I keep in there. Also my phone, because, and my keys, and my wallet, because I learned the hard lesson. I believe in like 1 week last summer, I lost my keys, I lost my phone, I lost my wallet. It was just all a disaster, guys. I destroyed everything. I about dropped everything. My keys flew out. That's for videos last year. You can go watch them. So as you guys can tell, this is my live well, and I got these Newport Products ventilation systems. I am not going to preach about any other product rather than this, and I am sponsored by this company. I've been with them for about, I'd say, 3 years, maybe 4 years now. And I do not believe in anything more than this. I've said this in my videos. I want to do a giveaway and give some out to some of you guys, because I really want you guys to put them on your boat and try them and really see the difference. What this is going to do is this little ventilation system where the oxygen is going to go in when I'm driving, and it's going to push all the bad air out. So what's going to happen is it's going to keep those fish, they're going to be a lot more hyper. I promise you, when I put the fish in the live well, he's more hyper when I'm taking him out. I promise you. If you guys watch my tournament videos where I'm taking the fish out of the live well, most of the time I could barely grab him, because I'm telling you, these things really do help. I don't even use, you know, an oxygenator anymore. G-juice I rarely use. I have some. But for the most part, guys, these things are just stellar. I believe you can get them for $49.99. It's literally nothing. They're so easy to install. I actually have a video on my channel if you want to go watch that. I'll literally show you guys how to install them. I just get a hole saw, pop the hole through, and literally just drill them right in. Simple as that. This compartment over here is gonna be a little bit more interesting than that one, so I'm gonna show you guys this one first. As you guys can tell, I got some more baits in this one, and I actually have a topwater box, chatterbait box, jig box, lipless crankbait / rattle trap box, frog box, swim jig box, big swim bait box, and also some crankbaits. I have like some DT6s and some square bills in there, more of shallow water crankbaits, not like 6XDs and everything. Like I said, when I move lakes and when I travel around, that's when I'm pretty much gonna change everything out. Last compartment right here, very, very simple, guys. As I said in my last episode, I told you guys this is pretty much my box where if I have a co-angler, you know, hopping on the boat, this is pretty much, I'm gonna have this compartment empty for the most part. But as of right now, I'm not fishing any tournaments. I haven't really had anyone traveling out to me. So right here, I have a box with some buoys in it, some spare baits, some spare reels that I just keep everything in that. And also I have two Bass Pro Shop bags with some tackle I just bought. Then my prop wrench right there. As you can tell, you gotta keep that on the boat. You never know what's gonna happen. And that's about it for that compartment. Very simple. I usually keep it wiped out for 99% of the time, it's empty. One of my favorite things about the boat, probably one of my like number one things I love about the boat, is the nav lights. I got the nav lights right here. These are my front lights. Instead of having, you know, the pole in the front that sticks in, I have the two on each side. Then in the back, this is actually something new I just added on. I have the light right up here on the power pole. You know, usually I'll have it right here. I have my pole stuck in right here. And before a tournament, you know, you're obviously gonna have to put your lights in and everything. And I know it seems like, you know, that's not much work, but when you actually have both of those already connected, literally this is all I have to do. When my boat's turned on and everything, I literally just have to hit the nav light button and then they both turn on. It's not like I have to go grab the poles and put them in. I know that seems super simple, like why should I complain about that? But it just makes your life, everything 100 times easier. One big shout out is to Lanier Propeller. They always hook me up with all my props and everything. I actually don't have my new prop on right now. He's working on it. A stellar guy over there. I mean, they really treat me well. Whenever I need a prop or I need my prop fixed, or, you know, I get a little ding in it or whatever it is, you know, I call him up. He's always on it. And, you know, if I have a tournament coming up, he's always there for me. He's making everything happen. Big shout out to Lanier. The most important thing I actually forgot to say, What kind of boat do I have? It's a Ranger Z5 20C 2014. I've had it for a while now. I've had the wrap on for about, I'd say pushing about 3 years. Yeah, 3 years now. I've had the wrap on. It's a phenomenal boat. I absolutely love it. You know, before we had a 2006 Ranger, moved over to this one. Possibly going to be getting a new one soon. Hint, 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 hint. Because we're getting a lot of hours on the motor. So, you know, we're having to make moves, having to figure out what we're going to do next and everything. But more than likely going to get another Ranger. Rangers are just, guys, come on now. Rangers are literally just, I love it. I can't get enough of them. They take waves so good. You know, they don't have as much speed as many of the boats, but mine, with the right prop on it, I promise you I can hit 75, 76. There's at one point in time I was hitting 78. Right now I'm probably only hitting 72 just because of my prop. Once I get the new one on there, I should be hitting 75, no problem. I did hit 78 before, which is very, very fast for a Ranger. This thing just rides so good. It's just more of a luxury. Rangers are just phenomenal, really, really phenomenal boat. But guys, that's gonna be it for the boat tour. I know you guys have been asking for this for such a long time, and I'm finally getting out here to do it in 150 degree weather, because guys, I'm sweating. It's seriously hot out here. I was out on the lake this afternoon. Got super burnt. It was just, guys, it's rough out here. But I'm making these videos for you guys because I really appreciate the support, all the love you guys are showing all my videos. Thank you guys so much. Be sure to drop a like on this video if you guys enjoyed this one. Stay tuned for the next episode where me and my dad actually went go-kart racing. It's a little bit different. It's for Father's Day. It's a lot of good stuff. We actually crashed into each other. It's a good one. You guys want to watch that one on Tuesday. So be sure to stay tuned for that video, guys. I want you guys to comment below. Since it's super hot outside, what's your favorite ice cream? I know that's random, but like, what's your favorite ice cream? Comment below, what's your favorite ice cream? Whether it's a slushy, popsicle, ice cream cone, cup, whatever it is, guys. Whether it's a Blizzard for Dairy Queen, let me know below, guys. Thank you guys so much for the support. I love you guys so much. Turn on post notifications. I'll catch you guys in the next video.